Hello and welcome to my channel. Make sure you hit the like, hit the share, subscribe if you haven't already. This is just going to be an update and a flashback because as you can see with the propaganda, there's news. But unfortunately, the judge hasn't ruled on this hearing that was in place today about this conflict. Now, according to articles, the conflict being mentioned is the relationship in question between Nicole Becker and Azriel Clary and Joycelyn Savage. And I just find that interesting considering all the things we've seen up until this point, and they wait until this very moment to make this conflict of interest known. Now, according to Greenberg, he has written information or written affidavit from Clary stating that she was not underage dealing with R. Kelly and disputes a lot of the propaganda that has been put on the internet. Nonetheless, as I've mentioned in previous videos, there's so many conflicts across the board. How can you continue to take these allegations serious? I mean, this whole narrative has fallen apart from the accusers to the attorneys to the prosecutors to everyone who has put their hands on this case. So what does that say when all these people are so convinced that just because these people got a indictment, that means the things in the indictment are true? They forget that they still have to put all of this so-called evidence in court, and R. Kelly has got to be convicted without reasonable doubt in the court of law, not on social media. And as you'll come to find, in most cases, majority of the things that you'll find on the internet and on social media will be completely in opposition to the legal documents. I have attached the links to these articles that I referenced in my community tab, so make sure you go read them yourself. And stay tuned for the rest of this video as we're going to keep putting in their face how this whole thing came into play and the fact that Timothy Savage had no case, therefore he involved all these people for his own gratification. At the end of the day, we'll see how all these allegations pile up in court. It's crazy to me how it seems that real domestic instances are being normalized, and when we see public displays of domestic abuse, we laugh it off and joke about it and say this is bagos. But we don't never bring this into the forefront when all these people come out with these allegations spawning this Me Too movement.
Yo, niggas talk crazy on tweets. They don't want it cause I come to the V. They don't want it. I peek, these niggas all sweet. Weak bamboo sticks out in the Jeep. It's a new weirdo every week.
You want your wife, you allow your wife to run around talk about some, oh, they felons, so felons thin. Else, shit. Play no games with me, man. Don't play no games with me, man. And this right here, like I said, and this to everybody, and everybody that's telling the truth. I'm not gonna tell y'all how to fight. Because he is, at the end of the day, he is a father, and that is a mother, and they fight for their child. What I don't do, I don't let my children disrespect grown-ass people. That's why I apologize for Gayle King, for my daughter, who is not around in my presence right now. I'm damn sure not let my daughter Isis, or my sons, or nobody else, and they grown, get into adult conversation, grown conversation, and disrespect. So that's why I don't, you know, reply to certain things that I hear. But one thing is, me as a parent, I'm going to check it. Because my children can get real vicious out their mouth and ready to go to war at any time. I don't do that. So I advise you to check your family and watch that disrespect that come out about the clerics. And that's all I'm going to say to you, bro. I don't get into none of that other shit. I'm not saying nothing else. You don't have to call me, none of that. But I'm going to tell you like this, keep my name out your mouth. Fight for your daughter. Pay attention to that. And I'm going to pay attention to mine. My name on some shit that you put me in. So don't fucking ever tell nobody, oh, I better stay low and stay out of it because I'm worried. Nigga, I ain't worried about shit. I need to get off 10, 15 pounds. I can do 30 days or whatever the fuck come to me. You better ask yourself, can you, when you running around here going to these motherfucking courthouses and lying on people? And don't let this fame fuck you up, man. This fame so small with no benefits. With no benefits.
It was all good in the hood until all these lies began to come out in the open. And all this propaganda that was put on the internet and social media is coming back to bite these so-called witnesses in the butt. I recognize that a lot of this propaganda being dispersed throughout social media was going in one direction. So when I begin to bring it to to YouTube, and a specific individual pretty much told me that some of the information I got came from him, it became very clear to me what was going on. So when I noticed that people would go from platform to platform within supporters, I decided to change up how I would deliver my messages. Let's go back to the source of a lot of this storyline, in which Cheryl Mack was the person who had this talent agency and was also an assistant to R. Kelly. Well, apparently she's the one who introduced Joycelyn to the whomever, Kevin Giles, I reckon, and that is how that whole thing was set up. The problem I have is, if you go to the indictments, you will see neither one of these people listed. So that would dispute a lot of these narratives I keep hearing these people go with, when all they're doing is switching out these stories and characters on the internet. All these people, if you line up the stories, are one and the same. Take JP for an example. Doesn't that sound exactly identical to this Precious Way story? Then I had to start considering the fact that a lot of these people making these allegations against R. Kelly are still being followed and engaged by these people that say they're in R. Kelly's inner circle. So that would obviously show you why I never relied on anybody claiming to currently be in R. Kelly's inner circle. However, I watch everybody equally the same. Take Asante McGee for another example. Doesn't her story sound identical to the deposition or this book that was released by Cheryl Mack? Remember when Tasha K had blasted this whole thing, in which she pretty much was trying to pen this book about R. Kelly? Meanwhile, her son is being accused of being a womanizer and deadbeat dad, and she's over here focused on what she's claiming she stood around for years watching R. Kelly do. Makes no sense. So, seemed like to me a little bit of bait and switch, which is what I've noticed throughout this whole case. Now, once you put all this together, regardless of who you're talking about involving this whole debacle, whether it's supporters, witnesses, accusers, whomever, if you just go down the line and look at all the inconsistencies, what I have demonstrated via YouTube should be very clear. However, as we know with these platforms, it's only so much you can say.
Why the fuck these niggas wanna go against the grain? Yeah. Why the fuck these niggas wanna drag a nigga name? The jury don't want me to make it. The DA, I know that he working.
Oh, he working.
Prosecutors wanna have me.